future of work is here, in this room, and it's inclusive. And everyone who's in this room is seeing headlines every single day. But make no mistake, that artificial intelligence, beyond everything that you're seeing in the news today, artificial intelligence is the great story of our time. And one of the troubling things that I think we often see when that headline comes to the fore is you're gonna see numbers, scary numbers. 47% of jobs are going to go up in a puff of smoke as a result of algorithms, automation, and AI. And what are we gonna do about that? And what does that mean for diversity and inclusion in particular? And when you get down to the essence of this, is it sort of a capitalist dream or a labor nightmare? What's going to happen in the future? How can an inclusive future of work solve these issues? That's the question of our age. There are some jobs that will go away on the toe of this bell curve, but the vast majority won't. The vast majority will be enhanced or invented, jobs that we haven't thought of yet. Now, I'm really excited today to announce for everybody here where the hypothesis meets the reality. We have released through Axios Media, if you guys are familiar with Axios, the Cognizant Jobs of the Future Index. This is basically like a Dow Jones Industrial Average, and we can start to track over time the jobs of the future. And that's really, really exciting to be able to see how that plays out. This is Gemma, and Gemma is my daughter, and she loves math. And she accompanied me to the Aspen Global Leadership Network this summer. It was a great opportunity to have her there. She loves math. And I will tell you guys, any notion that there's this sort of self-fulfilling prophecy that women don't go into those fields is unacceptable to me. It's unacceptable. And so the future for me is very personal. Our job in the Center for the Future of Work is to shine a very bright light on what we see happening in the future for people who are out there doing great work,